Hallmark Original Pictures presents an instant family classic, Summers with My Slow Brother, starring a cast of people who make you say, oh, because you didn't think they were still acting. For example, Grant Cho.
Oh.
Rachel Lee Cook.
Oh.
David Faustino.
Oh.
And Robin Tunney.
Huh?
The bald-headed chick from Empire Records.
Huh.
Guys, could you turn that down? I'm trying to study for the SAT.
Hey, careful, Meg. Remember what happened the last time I had to choose between you and a TV? Don't worry, Meg's holding our stuff. Meg, don't drink that soda!
Oh, I love shopping at Christmas time.
Ugh, mall food courts are so depressing. You can always tell which fathers are disappointed in their sons because they eat lunch with their coats still on.
How's that food, dum-dum? Too bad eating ain't math, because then I'd have something to be proud of.
I want to go live with Mom.
I know. So do I.
Welcome to Tommy Bahama.
Yeah, you got anything for a poor fat person who wants to look like a rich fat person?
Of course.
Now, I'll mostly be hitting on waitresses who are too young and thin to ever be interested in me.
Hitting on them in a kindly, genial way?
No, in a threatening, creepy, I'm joking, but I'm not really joking way. You have anything for that?
Sir, what you're describing is precisely Mr. Bahama's vision.
Tommy Bahama. 5 million uncles can't be wrong.
Look at Cleveland over there. He's obviously cleaning his feet in the pool without making it look like he's cleaning his feet in the pool.
Oh, that's nice. That's a good temp. I wonder if this temp is the same on my other foot. Oh, yeah. Sure is a good day for it. Good day for these wet paintbrushes, too. Is the pool too warm for paintbrushes?
Come on, guys, it's game time!
Yeah, Patriots!
Yeah, right! This is the greatest Sunday tradition ever. Except for getting all my cutaway gags ready for the week. Okay, my great-uncle wears a ski hat all the time. Griffin will be followed by Nick Nolte's handkerchief, followed by Japanese Abe Lincoln, and then Monkey Rabbi. Hey, where's the Monkey Rabbi? Here's your Torah. You'll be here on Tuesday at 9. Check in with Shirley.
You gonna need me this week?
Maybe. Maybe Friday. Now, where are the gays?
Over here.
No, the really cartoony gays.
Yoo-hoo!
There you are. We're gonna need you guys all week.
Are you sure? That sounds so serious.
I'm afraid his behavior has been an issue for a while. He's even been bothering students during nap time.
Hey, you up? Guess where I have a crayon.
Hey, you know what? Joe's our friend. He should be with his dad on Father's Day. And we're gonna track him down.
Yeah, that's a good idea, Peter.
Well, I like helping people out. That's why I was such a good breakup rodeo clown.
I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you. I've been sleeping with your sister.
What?
Hey now, over here, over here, over here. Hey now, over here, over here. Hey now, over here, over here. Oh, and now that I'm inside the barrel, he gave you and your sister HPV.
Daddy.
Yeah, but how come Babs couldn't come?
Oh, she wanted to be here, but she got hired to be the stuffy old woman who slowly comes around to it in a rap video.
I'm so glad the times are not changing.
You a bitch, and a hoe, and a hoe, and a bitch!
My garden party has been ruined! But I'm beginning to tap my foot!
I don't believe it!
That's so cool! Hey, what's Dad doing over there with Chris?
Oh, he's telling him that he's no longer his favorite son.
No! No, Daddy! Daddy! Daddy!
I didn't even tell him. He just does not like to be touched. Man, I haven't made money this easy since I invented the Yankin.
Peter, what's wrong?
Well, I want to masturbate, but I'm just so darn cold.
Too bad there's no answer for that problem.
But now there is. Hi, I'm Peter Griffin, creator of the Yankin. If you're anything like me, the number one problem in your life is that you can't masturbate just anywhere. But now you can. Introducing the Yankin. The only blanket with built-in decoy arms. Our patented process makes it look like you're holding the remote or sipping a beer. Meanwhile, your real hands are under the blanket, going to town.
Peter, what are you doing?
Nothing. Let's watch a Scarlett Johansson movie. But wait, there's more. We have Yankets for all occasions. Sporting events. At the supermarket. On the job.
Hey, what's going on under that blanket?
You'll never know.
Good evening and welcome to Smitty's. I'll be back with martinis for Mom and Dad, and for you kids, some martinis.
Dad, can you pass the bread?
Sure. But don't forget the butter that looks like decorative bathroom soaps and is impossible to smear.
Thanks, Dad. This really ruins it.
What will you be having, sir?
Yes, I'll have what I had last time, pheasant on the glass.
Don't you mean pheasant under glass?
Nope. Yeah, now turn around and lay an egg on the glass. Ah, yeah. I defy you to tell me exactly what's wrong with this. I wouldn't worry, Lois. I never did very well in school either. I even failed homeroom.
Peter Griffin?
There.
Oh, man, there she is.
What? Who?
That girl, right there. She comes in here every morning after her run. Oh, I'm obsessed with her.
Well, why don't you go talk to her?
Way ahead of you.
Where are you going?
And 1,000. Phew!
1,000 what?
Percent, that's what. You in the game, too?
You mean running?
Let me think what's on my trophies. Yes.
You're losing her.
Hey, I'm Brian.
Hi, I'm Chloe. Nice to meet you.
Hey, you wouldn't maybe want to grab a bite to eat sometime, would you?
That sounds great.
Awesome. You know, see, this is how you meet people. I tried the online dating thing, but there's just too much competition out there.
Short but handsome, slightly hairy, newly single salesman. Short but handsome, slightly hairy, newly single salesman. Short but handsome, slightly hairy, newly single salesman. Hi, I'm Al Harrington of Al Harrington's Wacky Waving Inflatable Arm Flailing Tube Man Warehouse and Emporium. Due to a gut-busting divorce, limited people skills, and significant prodding from my therapist, I am currently seeking online companionship as a short but handsome, slightly hairy, newly single salesman. And I would love to attempt to convert my heavily embellished internet profile and carefully airbrushed out-of-date photo into a night of physical intimacy with you!
You really think Meg is college material, Principal Shepard?
Yeah, she's a solid B student, and that's quite an accomplishment, considering none of her teachers are willing to sleep with her.
Sophomore year, she was molested by the janitor. Does that help?
Mr. Griffin, I believe they're called custodians. Anyway, I was able to get Meg an interview this weekend at Green Mountain College in Vermont.
Green Mountain College? Oh my God, that's my first choice. Can one of you guys take me up there?
Meg, please excuse your mother and I for a moment. We need to work out our schedules. I'd be happy to take you, Meg.
We now return to Extreme Makeover, Bethany Frankel edition.
Move that bus! Put that bus back!
Hey, can you guys turn that down? I'm trying to read.
Oh, shut up, Brian. We were here first.
Yeah, Brian. Go read in your own room.
I don't have my own room.
Yes, you do. You have that wicker basket in the laundry room with the frayed bath mat in it.
God, I can't get any peace and quiet in this house.
Well, now you know how I felt at Mardi Gras. Hey, keep it down. Trying to get some sleep up here.
Show us your boobs.
My boobs? I don't think I...
Oh, my. Jewelry.
I wonder what I'll get for showing this. The rules of this city are very unclear. Breath, it's 15 feet from your door to mine.
Aw, what's the matter, Stewie? You a little scared in here? Don't worry, there's no monsters.
Of course there's no monsters.
Or are you worried about what happened to that family down the street? Those three guys broke in, beat up the father with a croquet mallet, and then stole a baby, and nobody knows where the baby is now? Is that what you're thinking about, buddy?
I am now.
Tell you what, Daddy will read you a bedtime story. Oh, man, I've been dying to see Maniac Pope 2. The first one was awesome.
Is this one of those theaters where they bring your beef stew right to your seat?
What? That's not a thing.
Sure is. Don't get mad at me because you don't know nothing fancy.
I feel like I'm being watched.
Of course you are, silly. The Lord is always watching us.
May the sword be with you. And also with you.
Jeez, this movie sucks.
I know, it's terrible.
Excuse me, who had the stroganoff with the roasted potatoes?
Right here.